Are you curious about passive houses, but are not sure if they're the right choice for you? My name is Anton Dobrovsky, I'm a passive house professional, and if you're interested in learning about energy efficient buildings, stay tuned because in this video we're going to be discussing the 6 myths about the passive house standard and see if they're true or not. So let's start with myth number 1. Passive house buildings are boxy and ugly. Well, some people believe that passive house buildings are unattractive or that they should look like shoeboxes because they should be also very energy efficient, which is not true. In reality, passive houses can be designed in any shape and style. They can be modern or traditional, they can be made to blend in seamlessly in their surroundings, or they can have also some crazy parametric designs. In fact, many passive houses are known for their beautiful and innovative designs. And remember, the passive house standard is not a prescription-based standard. It is a performance-based standard. So you can design a passive house in any kind of architectural style as far as you achieve the energy efficiency level of passive house. And now we come to myth number 2. Passive houses are airtight, so the air must be stuffy and humid. For many years, people have believed that our buildings should have air leaks and that they should be ventilated through gaps in the walls, the roof, and the floors. And this misconception has led people also to believe that airtight buildings are unhealthy and that there isn't going to be any fresh air in them. And that, I would say that's partially correct, because if you only have an airtight building, well, the air is not going to be ventilated, you're not going to get fresh air inside, and the stale air is going to stay inside of this airtight house. But this couldn't be further from the truth about passive houses. And that's the main reason why we have a ventilation system with heat recovery. This system brings in the fresh air from the outside and extracts the stale air from the house. And this ensures that the air inside of a passive house is always fresh and healthy, even when the building is very airtight. And as passive house professionals, therefore, we say, build tight and ventilate right. And in fact, many studies have shown and proved that the indoor air quality in passive houses is much better than the one in traditional homes because of the efficient ventilation system. And this leads us to myth number 3, namely that you cannot open the windows in a passive house building. Who wants to live in a building in which you cannot open the windows, right? But before we debunk this myth, let's take a step back and take a look into why do we even open the windows in the first place? Well, for most of us, we do it to bring in the fresh air, to remove the stale air from the building, and opening the windows is also a great way to regulate the temperatures inside. So, why do people believe that in a passive house you cannot open the windows? Well, it stems from the fact that in a passive house, you do not have to open the windows. Because, as already mentioned, you have the mechanical ventilation system with heat recovery, which constantly brings in fresh air. So throughout the whole year inside of the building, you're gonna have fresh and clean air, and you just do not have the necessity to open the windows. But this does not mean that you cannot open the windows. So in a passive house, you can open the windows. And this leads us to myth number 4. One of the most common myths about the passive house standard is that passive houses are too expensive. And that's not entirely true. It is believed so because the additional initial investment to achieve the passive house standard is slightly higher compared to conventional buildings. But this does not take into account the operational costs, which have a significant role in the overall cost of a building. Because you build a building once, but you're gonna use it for 50 or even 100 years. And passive houses are designed to be extremely energy efficient, and they significantly reduce the energy consumption of the building and also the energy bills of the building. In fact, studies have shown that passive houses can reduce the energy consumption up to 90% compared to traditional houses. Moreover, the additional investment to achieve the passive house standard becomes lower and lower because the popularity and access to components has increased worldwide and because building codes are getting closer and closer to the passive house standard. Another thing to mention here is the return on the additional investment. So usually the return on the additional initial investment for a passive house is between 5 and 10 years, which means that after the 10th year, you will only be saving money due to the low energy bills. So when you do it right. Invest in energy efficiency now, because you're going to be saving throughout this whole time when you're going to be using the building for all the years after that. So no, passive houses are not too expensive, And even when we look at the cost of the house or of a building, over a 20-year period, passive houses are cheaper than conventional buildings. And now we come to myth number 5. Passive house buildings are made only for Germany and only for houses. And yes, the passive house standard is made in Germany, that's where it originates from, but it is not made for Germany. The passive house standard is international and it can be implemented in any kind of climate anywhere over the world. And not only that, but it can be applied to more than just houses. I know it can be a bit confusing, but that's why I say passive house buildings, because we do not only have houses, we also have kindergartens, schools, office buildings, even skyscrapers, which are built to the passive house standard. And even old and existing buildings can be retrofitted by following the passive house principles. So the passive house standard is a worldwide standard and it is for any type of buildings. And now we come to myth number 6. Passive house is too complicated. Some people believe that passive house is too complicated and too difficult to understand. But that's not entirely true. Because, yeah, passive house does require attention to detail and careful planning, but the principles that lie behind the passive house standard are simple and straightforward. In fact, many architects and builders find that after they learn the passive house principles, it is much easier for them to design and build high-performance buildings. And I'm saying this from personal experience, because at the passive house school, we've taught hundreds of people from all over the world about the passive house principles. We've taught architects, engineers, self-builders, but also lawyers, journalists, and business developers. So I'm sure that if they can learn about it, you can too. And if you want to learn what a passive house building is, make sure to check out my last video. I hope you enjoyed this one. Thanks for watching and see you next time.